Now, issues in the contemporary pursuit of ethnographic method. Organizing a Center for Ethnography after having moved to the University of California in 2005 has provided me and others an opportunity to think through modestly experiment with these forms of producing ethnography within and alongside the politics and dilemmas of establishing sites and conditions in the spirit of classic fieldwork, where sustained participant observation, dialogic engagement, and deep relationships, significant research could be cultivated. These classic modalities that define ethnography, you know, dialogic intensity, participant observation, and within deep local relationships are still its ideals, but they are much, much harder to achieve. And I would say that in many projects, they are not achieved as strongly as they were in classic projects. So there's a kind of incompleteness to the playing out of the kind of ideals which have defined the fundamentals of the ethnographic method. These are means for experimenting with textualizing of ethnography in the real time of fieldwork. So the pushing the idea of the text back into the doing of the ethnography makes the issues of writing culture relevant to fieldwork, not so much text. The tropes of or the rhetorics of ethnographic writing. The center has offered an opportunity to think about forms that would push the process of ethnographic writing back to the practical on-the-ground problems of constituting fieldwork in differently constructed worlds from the ground up. I think of this as anticipated in my interest in the emergence of multi-sited ethnography in the 1990s with its following metaphor as a condition of producing this kind of research similar to other research and theory imaginaries about, many people were thinking in this way at that time, about mobile or circulating processes of knowledge making that were in high fashion during that period, that the most influential remaining actor network theory associated with Latour, but much broader. However, today, that view of the social life of the ethnographic method is far too lonely. It should be imagined and challenged in addressing the problem anew of situating the virtues and effects of micro-scale ethnographic work in a networked, globalizing world of which collaboration has come to be the key, almost universal normative expression of desirable social relations. Ethnography remains multi-sided, but its composition cannot be comprehended by following and explaining processes that are authoritatively and aesthetically realized in resulting accounts. A key problem, collaboration is the trope which really interrupts the smooth writing, production of ethnography from fieldwork to text in the classic sense. The impulse, the norm to collaborate. I would also say that the other kind of, somewhat neoliberal, but that's a kind of, you know, explosive, that has sort of required the attention of ethnographers is the idea that ethnography and somehow produces or supports the idea of innovation. So collaboration and innovation are two key or kind of buzzwords that I think, and haven't been fully examined, that have deeply affected the creative processes and the epistemological processes that are embedded in the classic ethnographic method.